Welcome back to another episode of Fishing is My Summer Job. Today what I'm doing is I originally went in to catch some red horse suckers, as you would carp on the small little flies up in a flat area that's near this, and they did not want to cooperate. I did hook three, didn't get them on film. They jumped and they ran and I couldn't land them. But I did get like one smallmouth here and one other one. Nothing giant, nothing to brag about, but a lot of fun. As you can see, the water's a little murky. That led to some problems with the red horse suckers trying to see where they're at. This segment, I'm fishing later at night, a different day. This is a segment of the river that I fished that I haven't been on in a number of years. I fished the deeper section first and just couldn't get any bites. I went up and fished where there's a riffle and the water's dropping out of the riffle, probably more oxygenated water. And I got like three, you know, okay smallmouth, nothing to brag about right off the bat. Which was a lot of fun. Yeah, the fish really were acrobatic tonight. I mean, every one of them I caught shot up, jumped a bunch, ran a lot. It was a lot of fun. Like I say, it was a section of the river that I will go back to again, probably when there's more light so I can see the bottom structure a little better. That flood that we had changed it all. This area I'm fishing here used to be really shallow, and it was surprisingly deep. Coming out of that riffle, it went from knee-deep to waist-deep, where it always used to be shallower. Yeah, if you watch, I'm going to net this fish. I probably didn't need to. That's my measure net. It's got marks. Each mark's got a number on it. If you add the two numbers together, it'll give the length of the fish. That's how I get the measurements on my fish. For the final segment, I'm back fishing a shallower section of the river. I'm fishing it kind of early morning. I wanted to beat the canoe traffic. What's kind of interesting here is I'm fishing a fly that I picked up in at the Orvis shop in Chicago. It's actually a saltwater fly. It's set for fishing bonefish and stuff like that. It kind of looks like a shrimp. It's got a little twister tail on it. If you're hitting fly shops and you're seeing unique patterns that are the right size and different than what the fish might see, that's always something good to try. I picked up a bunch of these. They sold out of them. I haven't seen them since. I've got a little picture I keep on my phone every single fly shop I go to. I'm looking for this fly because it is a nice pattern, but it's kind of a clear silver tinsel with a just a little almost translucent twister tail, just enough to put a little vibration in the water, and it really takes some hits, especially if you're fishing for rock bass and smallmouth. And like I say, in this section again, I'm targeting areas where I can see rock, and you'd be amazed once you get the first fish how many are willing to go. This is an area that I usually take my time on, and like I say, there's usually 4 to 10 fish in a spot. I think I counted over 60 fish when I fished this segment. I obviously can put them all on film. They're all basically the same. They're that 8 to 10 inch fish, a few bigger ones mixed in, but a lot of fun. If you're looking for a type of stream or type of water to get a new fly fisherman started in, this is the type. Just about every river that we have in the state of Michigan has got a section. It's shallow, there's some nice ripples in it, and you can get them on some fish. So, thanks again for watching Fishing is My Summer Job. Next week, I'm looking to have some more lake trout fishing from Higgins Lake.